All right, take me through.
Okay, so the first thing I want to say is I think it's awesome that you made me do this quiz. The second thing I want to say is, in some sense, every single one of them is correct.
Yay!
But you put radio buttons down, not checkbox buttons, thingies, so I have to pick one. So let's just go through. Figuring out the best line to wait in, well, that is a queue, Q-U-E-U-E, which would make a lot of sense if I were, say, English.
Yes, that's right. In fact, you are in this picture.
Oh, yeah. That's the English version of Charles, the one with the top hat. Okay.
Yeah, and a cane, too.
Yeah, I like it. And a cane, yes. Well, that is typically what I do whenever I go to London. Discovering when to come in for your line, that is also cue learning, though a different kind of cue. Q-U-E learning. The third, practicing your best bank shot, although I probably would have said break shot.
Ooh, nice.
That is also cue learning.
And it's the same spelling.
It's the same spelling.
That's unfortunate.
Well, you pronounce one Q and you pronounce the other one Q.
Yes, well, clearly. And I spelled them that way, too.
Yeah, and I know. I can see where the emphasis is. And the fourth one is evaluating the Bellman equations from data. That is, you take in states, the actions, rewards, and the next states, and you try to learn an actual Q function, which is just the letter Q. So that is Q learning and is the only one that is spelled correctly. And so that is the choice that I would make.
All right. So just to be clear here, so this all... The purpose here, other than to
demonstrate your ability to show puns,
is that it's just to give the definition. So that's what Q learning is going to be doing is it's going to use transitions, that is to say data, to directly produce the solution to those Q equations.